हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, हाउ आर यू? आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर हैप्पी एंड हेल्दी। सो डियर स्टूडेंट, एज यू कैन सी, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी योर इंग्लिश लिटरेचर फर्स्ट चैप्टर एंड अनकंफर्टेबल बेड। ओके, सो डियर, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द चैप्टर, लेट सी फ्यू लाइन्स अबाउट द ऑथर। ओके, सो वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज हियर, हु इज द ऑथर of this lesson? So dear, you can see Mr. Guy D. Maupassant is the author of this chapter. Okay, he was born on 5th August 1850. Is that clear? He was born on 5th August 1850. He was a 19th century French author. Okay, he belonged to 19th century. Okay, and he was a French author. He was a novelist, short story writer, and a poet. Mr. Guy D. was a novelist, short story writer, and a poet. Is that clear? He wrote around 300 short stories along with a few novels. Is that clear? Mr. Guy D. Maupassant wrote almost 300 short stories along with a few novels. The Necklace and an Uncomfortable Bed are his most famous stories. Okay, if we talks about his death, then he was died on 6th July 1893. Okay, he was died on 6th July 1893. Okay dear, so I hope you have got the basic introduction about the author. Now see the paragraphs line by line. So dear student, take a pencil and whenever I explain any difficult word, then you must underline the word and write the meaning of the word. Okay, so student, very first I would like to tell you that the chapter An Uncomfortable Bed has been written in the form of autobiography. Okay, this is a autobiography of the author, Mr. Guy D. Maupassant. So I hope you have got my points very well. So let's start the video. Okay, let's see. One autumn I went to spend a few days with some friends in Picardy. Okay, so very first thing, what the word I referred here, to whom the word I referred in the chapter. So dear, as I have told you, this is the autobiographical touch. The lesson has a autobiographical touch. So the word I referred to the author, Mr. Guy D. Maupassant. Is that clear? Okay, so it was the autumn season. Okay, it was the autumn season, and Mr. Guy D. Maupassant had gone to spend a few days with his some friends in Picardy. What is the meaning of Picardy? So dear student, Picardy is a area, it is a region in the northern France. Okay, so Mr. Guy D. Maupassant had gone to spend some holidays, to spend few days with his best friends. Okay, now see question, paragraph second. My friends were fond of practical jokes. So dear student, what is the meaning of practical jokes? So dear, practical jokes means prank. You have heard the word prank. It is very common nowadays. You can see a lots of video on YouTube. Okay, on prank. Okay, prank means to make joke. Okay, to make fun. So my friends were fond of practical jokes. So here the author, Mr. Guy D. Maupassant, tells us that his friends were fond of pranks. Okay, they love to do jokes. Okay dear, now see further. I do not care to know people who are not. Okay, the author tells us that he does not care. Okay, he does not try to know the people who are very prank or not. Okay, he never care for that. Now see paragraph third. When I arrived दे गेव मी अ ग्रैंड रिसेप्शन विच एट वंस मेड मी रैदर सस्पिशियस. ओके, सो एज वी नो दैट द ऑथर इज गोइंग टू स्पेंड हिज फ्यू डेज विथ हिज फ्रेंड एंड वेयर ही वॉज गोइंग ही वॉज गोइंग टू पिकार्डी. सो वेन द ऑथर अराइव्ड एट हिज डेस्टिनेशन when he arrived at his destination, okay, he was welcome. What is the meaning of reception? So student, reception means to welcome, okay. So he was welcomed, okay, he was warm welcome by his friends. His friends welcomed him very in a grand manner, okay, which at once made me rather suspicious. And to have a such grand welcome, the author was got puzzled. Okay, he became doubtful that there is something wrong. Okay, he could not adjust the grand welcome by his friends. Okay, because it may be he had never got such grand welcome ever in his life. So that is why he was a little bit suspicious. Why his friend had such grand welcome for him. Okay, now see further. They cheered loudly, embraced me and made much of me. Okay, then he tells us that his friend cheered him loudly, they embraced him, they hugged him and made much of me. What is the meaning of made much of me? Okay, it means to say they gave him a lot of attention and importance. Is that clear? Made much of me means his friends gave him a lot of attention and importance. Okay, as if they expected to have great fun at my expense. What is the meaning of at my expense? Okay, dear student, at my expense means with him as the target of a joke. Okay, the author tells us that he expected, okay, he feels that they had expected to have a great fun, okay, to have a great fun with him, okay, as the target of a joke. Okay, it means to say he feels that his friend had made him target for the prank, target for the joke. Okay students, now see paragraph 4th. I said to myself, look out, old ferret, they have something in store for you. Okay, so now see, in this sentence, the author, okay, I have told you already, the author was suspicious to have a grand welcome. Okay, he was a little bit in doubt. So he talked to himself, okay, he addressed himself, okay, an old ferret. What is an old ferret? So dear student, ferret is a small cat like animal. Okay, it is a small cat like animal which haunts rabbit by entering their burrows and driving them out. Okay, so he calls himself an old ferret. And now see further, they have something in store for you. And he thought himself that his friend had planned something for him. Okay, so he just imagined that his friend must have planned something big, okay, something big prank for him. So that is why he was a little bit doubtful. Okay, now see paragraph 5th. During the dinner, the mirth was excessive. Okay, now it was the time of dinner. Okay, all his friends and author were taking their dinners. So the author tells us that when they were taking dinner, okay, so student, what is the meaning of mirth? M-I-R-T-H. So student, what is the meaning of mirth? Mirth means students, happiness. Mirth means happiness. Okay, so he tells that they were a lots of happy. Okay, the atmosphere, okay, at the time of dinner was more happiness. ओके, इट वॉज समथिंग मोर, इट सिम इट अपियर्स मोर हैप्पी दैन शुड बी, ओके, बियॉन्ड द प्रॉपर लिमिट, ओके, ही नेवर एक्सपेक्ट सच टाइप्स ऑफ हैप्पीनेस, दैट इज वाई ही वॉज नॉट श्योर दैट हिज फ्रेंड्स आर नॉट गोइंग टू प्रैंक हिम, ओके, ही वॉज डाउटफुल. I thought, here are people who are really amused, too amused. He thought that his friends are too much amused, okay? His friends are too much happy, okay? Beyond the limit, okay? Beyond the limit. So that is why he was completely doubtful, okay? That there was something wrong with him, okay? Now see further. There does not seem to be any reason for so much mirth. The author was doubtful, okay, he does not have any reason, okay, any fixed reason for so much amusement, for so much gladness, okay, he does not understand why his friends are too much glad and too much happy on that day, okay, there was no any certain reason. So let's see. They must have planned some good joke. The author predicted, he guessed that his friend must have planned some good prank for him, some good joke for him. Surely I am to be the victim of the joke. What is the meaning of victim? Victim of the joke. So student, victim of the joke means the person whom the others play a prank upon. So he tells us that he is sure that he is about to the victim of the joke. Okay, he is the person whom his friends play a prank upon. Okay, he tells that he is the person. Okay, and his friend has planned a great prank for him. 110% he is going to be victim of his friends. Okay, dear students. Okay. So dear student, I hope you have got this all lines very well. So till then, watch the video. We will continue from paragraph 6 in the next class. Okay, till then, enjoy the video and take care.